Good morning. Breaking gravitational forces. God in his infinite wisdom created a powerful and an invisible force that holds every single object on earth in place. In fact, both animate and inanimate life is helplessly under the influence of gravity. And as you read this morning, internally, you have your own gravitational forces acting on your thoughts, feelings, and actions. Yes, you have those personality traits that are so powerful, you are helplessly under their influences. Mediocrity is the force that tells you your current circumstance is better than what should be or could be. It restricts your vision to your immediate environment and blinds you to a better version of yourself or your life. Procrastination is another force that says even if you see a better version of yourself, you can drag your feet to the destination. Procrastination convinces you that there is more time to accomplish, that tomorrow will be a better day to see your dreams come to pass. Indiscipline is another helpless gravitational pull that says what God is telling you doesn't require your all. Or you can go to sleep on the promptings of God on your heart. Do it when you feel like and do it anyway, anyhow. Underlining all these forces is the dominant force of fear. A cloud of negativity which is constantly whispering, you cannot do it. You cannot become what God is telling you. That dream is too big, too exponential for God to do it. Unfortunately, every single person on earth is helplessly a subject to fear to some degree. Jesus, as a man, was also subject to these forces. In Gethsemane, we see the most critical hour of his earthly mission. His three most trusted companions, who were supposed to help him pray, were sound asleep. Internally, Jesus was overwhelmed with the sheer gravity of his impending pain and crucifixion. At a point, he begged God to spare him the mission. But he persisted in prayer and was strengthened by an angel. After his death and resurrection, Jesus returned to the same site on the Mount of Olives to ascend to heaven. Acts chapter 1 verse 2. The very location of his unprecedented vulnerability is the exact location of his supernatural elevation. As he rose, he violated all the laws of gravity. He exerted his authority over the natural forces that should typically hold him back. And as you read or listen this morning, Jesus Christ is seated on the right-hand side of God. Praise God. The good news is, he is not there alone. For all who will believe in him and welcome him as Lord, the scripture says God raised us up with Christ and seated us with him in the heavenly realms in Christ Jesus. Spiritually, you have also violated the laws of gravity in your life. God has elevated you above mediocrity. Spiritually, procrastination has lost its influence over your life. Indiscipline cannot hinder you with its ugly tentacles. Spiritually, fear and timidity has been overcome by the spirit of power and self-control. 2 Timothy chapter 1 verse 7. The year 2021 is prophetically your year to rise. Elevation is simply manifesting physically what already exists spiritually. Why sell yourself short? If you have made it as far as the heavenly realms, why conduct yourself as though you are still helpless under these negative influences? God has already done the heavy lifting. He wants you to see it, believe it, and walk in it. Starting this morning, write down all the areas in your life that you want to see exponential growth. And in a very honest way, please write down the internal forces that you identify to hold you back. Now stand on Ephesians chapter 2 verse 6 and begin to cross out these gravitational forces. For the rest of the month and all of 2021, the Grace Movement is committed to manifesting exponential elevation. On Friday night, we start our new series, which focuses on breaking down these gravitational forces that will cause you to elevate exponentially. Please join us on this super exciting journey. We are trusting God for an amazing time. God richly bless you. My name is Samuel Entribosiakum from the Grace Movement. God bless you and have a great day.